with the pedals. I've played around with different sounds in the past, but I've never really been a pedal guy. I've never even owned a big pedal board. The only effect I really use all the time is this Mulder XT tube overdrive. It's made by my friend Gary Mulder in Boulder, so it's convenient. I was using a different overdrive pedal for years when I was on the road, especially with Otis Taylor, and Gary came to one of my gigs and brought this pedal. So take it home and try it, and it blew everything away that I had played before as far as the sound that I'm looking for. I'm in an overdrive pedal, I'm looking for the sound of basically a tube amp cranked up. I don't like it to sound like I stomped on a box that changed the tone and colored it. And these do that better than any pedal I've ever used. So it's a real tube overdrive, by which I mean the tube is not for show. You can pull this tube out. This is a Mullard 12AX7. And you can take this tube out and swap them for different sounds. And so the idea is the overdrive knob is biasing the tube in real time, which is what creates more drive. And then other than that, all I got in line is a tuner, the Polytune. That's from TC Electronics. That's kept me going for, I think I've had it since I was 19, so they're sturdy. But that's it. And then just really high-end cables just a couple custom things. But yeah, just try to keep the signal chain really clear. I found that for me personally, a lot of effects is like kind of distracting, and I almost always, sometimes I'll think it's a good idea and I'll put some stuff out for the set and it'll be fun for a minute, but I always kind of go back to just these, you know? Even if I never return.